Even if I never got straight by my definition, I was going to need to follow Jesus. I was going to lay it down for him. I mean, if these women who want this thing that's really good are going to pursue God, even if they don't get it, and let him have them, even if they don't get what they want, then who am I to say, well, he's not making me straight, so I'm going to just forget this, right? It was very inspiring. It was very encouraging. It was also, in a way, affirmed my femininity. It's like, oh, this isn't really a gender problem. This is a lay my life before Christ problem, right? This is a me coming before Jesus. And as I did that more and recognized more that I wanted to let Jesus into all of me, I would say my healing sort of sped up a little bit. Instead of me fixating on, am I still attracted to women? Am I still attracted to women? And I had a lot of falls in that. I had a lot of moral failure, which was very painful and very frustrating. But basically, I thought, well, if God hasn't healed me, and I'm attracted to this person and she's attracted to me, then, but then I would confess right away. And God bless the women and men in my life who can maintain faith that God was doing a transformative work, because I don't know where they had a lot of faith. I think there was a strong community. I was part of a healing community that was committed to the betterment of all of the people and the healing of all of the people in the community. So they held out hope for me when I didn't have hope for me. And that was super duper important for them to quickly say, okay, well, lay that down and let's go before God and let him keep moving, keep having you. So there was healing of the trauma of abuse. There was healing of the trauma of divorce. There was forgiving my mother and then understanding the abuse that went on with my father and forgiving my father. There was just so much. And the more the Lord healed those things, the more I was able to pick up and embrace that which he had planted in me all along.